Hello everybody and welcome to week 2 of the GPC. This week we are facing a Togevar and the Timbers. The Portland Timbers or something like that. This week I brought my Mega Blast toys with this set. Workup, Substitute, Surf, Dragon, Pulse. I also brought an Assault Vest, Electivire with a Focus Blast, Volt Switch, Ice Punch, Thunder Punch. And I brought a Thunderbolt, Ice Beam, Recover Calm Mind, Latios with Icenium Z, because he is extremely ice weak. He has 8 ice weaknesses and 1 resist, and that is Vaporeon, which I have Thunderbolt for. And Thunderbolt also for Celesteela. So, my next Pokémon, Mr. Steelio Girl, Registeel, Ice Punch, Thunder Punch, Steltrock, Toxic. Should have put on like Explosion or something, probably would have helped. And Landorus, and I am going to put something over this item, because I don't want you guys to see it, because I might bring it again. Then I faced Togevar again, and I want it to be a secret. So, my next Pokémon for Memento for helping my Landorus, Sweep, Leech Seed, Substitute, and Moon Blast. With Leftovers, Prankster, of course. With these EVs, as you can see. So that's really kek. So, boy. Hello Bunny and welcome to the battle, and I already explained what I brought. So he brought his Mega Pidgeot, his Thunderous Therian, his Latias, his Celesteela, Lucha and Crocodile. As you can see, he has 5 ice weaknesses, and I lead off with my Latios, as he leads off with his Lucha, and I completely forgot he could have had a U-turn, but I didn't expect him to run U-turn, and he crit me. So that's perfect. I thought about going for the Sub-Zero Slammer this turn, but I didn't. As he went into Crocodile, so that would have been perfect. Anyway, I went to Registeel as he went into Crocodile, and now I went into my Whimsicott, which took the Earthquake with ease. Anyway, I predict him to switch out, but he doesn't, for some reason. So, I now set up a Substitute, which I should have done the turn before. Anyway, once Whimsicott gets up a Substitute or a Leech Seed, it's pretty much over, because he doesn't do shit to me every turn, because I get so much health back. Anyway, he goes into his Mega Pidgeot, which also can break my subs, but because of Leech Seed, it doesn't really work. I just whittle him down, eventually. As you can see, I've now 88%, and after this Leftovers and Leech Seed recovery, I have 81%, so he's doing 7% every turn. So that's absolutely perfect. He U-turns and only does damage. So he now goes into Hawlucha as I actually outspeed this. While I do have speed investments, but still, I don't naturally outspeed Hawlucha. Anyway, I Moonblasted as he now went to Mega Pidgeot. He went for the Heat Wave, which I kind of half forgot he had. Anyway, he goes to the U-turn. And I go for the Steltrox, as I now stay in, because I don't have Hawlucha switch ins, because I don't want my Landorus to switch in on my fucking Ice Punch or Hidden Power Ice. And he actually had Hidden Power Ice, so that's interesting. I'm kinda sad I didn't. It would have been fucking perfect. Well, the thing was, if he actually had killed my Registeel, would have been perfect setup for my Landorus, but he didn't. So anyway, he goes to his Celesteela as I Volt Switch out to get rid of his Substitute, as he tries to Whimsicott my Whimsicott, but I am of course immune. This I expected Leech Seed, so that's why I switched into this. Anyway, I go back into Electivire, which might not have been the best play, because Heavy Slam does a shit ton. And I didn't expect it to do so much. Anyway, I now go for the Volt Switch. And now I go for Focus Blast, but he switches out into Celesteela and I miss my Focus Blast, so that's not very nice. Anyway, I now go for Ice Punch because I expect him to go into Latias, which he does. And I dealt this damage on this Latias, and this damage showed me that he is in fact very defensive, but he also outsped me, which I didn't take into consideration, so it probably means he's max speed. Which he was, and I kind of just thought he was like defensive or something. Which, I sacked Latios for no reason and I lost the speed die. So that's fucking perfect. So I go into Whimsicott and I actually kill, which I did not expect at all. So that's perfect. Now he goes to Mega Pidgeot as I go into Maymantle, and even if he U-turned he wouldn't have switched out because there was nothing to U-turn. And I now can set up a free Rock Polish, and now I can set up a free Sword Stance. And now I pretty much win, because nothing on this team is going to take a plus 2 Stone Edge or Earthquake, or actually plus 1. What he could have done actually was maybe switch in like Mega Pidgeot and then back into Crocodile to get more Intimidate, but then I might be would have set up more. Anyway, I pretty much win right now because I one hit KO everything with Stonehenge. As he now baits out my Z move, which I don't have on this Pokemon. Anyway, I crit him with Stonehenge and now I pretty much
walk out the door. You see someone that you know and they ask you how you are, and you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
If you don't want to hear me bitch and whine, then you should probably click the video away. Don't take this too seriously. Half of it was for entertainment purposes. I know Anthony loves when I rage. Other half was because I'm salty. Because I'm a salty bitch. So that's a thing. I missed. I should have 100% won this game, but I don't, because I missed. I don't have Aqua Jet. Okay. So, yeah, I don't know what the fucking else I'm saying right now. Okay, they're all talking about percentages in the chat. 20% chance is a 20% chance. Thank you, George the Third. Thank you. He basically had a 50% chance of hitting 3 in a row. Well, only one of them was detrimental. So if I missed... wait, no, fuck off! Mega Pidgeot has no guard. So I always hit that one. So I only had to hit 2 actually. And one of them was detrimental versus Thunderous, and one of them wasn't versus the other, versus Celesteela, because I could take a Celesteela hit. So, okay, Pidgeot fucking has no guard. Doesn't even know it himself, apparently. Paul actually said not all were as critical. I'm not saying it isn't bullshit. I'm not saying I should have won. I'm not stupid. Shady, I mean, and George are talking some stupid shit. Uzi Gunner, my god, that's unfortunate. Oh well, GG boys, no it's not a GG. Uzi, there's only one god here, and he's on your screen right now. Properly named... that's why the replay was called God on the spreadsheet. God with a point. Well, fuck off. Have a great day. Thank you, Uzi Gunner. My day wasn't great. So that's that. The only thing that annoys me are people who try to justify it. Especially like, you have to hit three in a row. One of them guaranteed hit, so that didn't even count. So yeah, this sucks a lot because I have a really tough division. I need to get all the wins I can get. Should have been 2-0, now Chris is 2-0. I wanted to win, of course, so it definitely sucks. And shit like that, but this time I actually 110% lost to Hex. There's no fucking debate about it at all. So that's fucking perfect. I play Ethan next week. Very scary, he has 2 5-0s. And he has the matchup, I think, my Zygarde switch in doesn't really exist. Well, I guess it kinda does. I don't fucking know. I haven't really started building yet. I want to die. Oh.